CNBC TV 18 Weekender.
Welcome back. You're watching CNBC TV 18 Weekender. We have with us marathon man Milind Soman. Milind, you know, you have six ventures, United Sisters Foundation that runs the Pinkathon, Maximus Events, a TV production company, FaZe Entertainment Devi that you just launched this year, a spa development company, Goddess, a talent management company, Speaking Minds. You're pretty much a serial entrepreneur. What has been the biggest learning so far as entrepreneurship is concerned?
You need good partners.
Okay.
You do. I mean, yeah. There is nothing. I mean, if you look at the tagline behind,
together we'll do more.
Exactly. I mean, I believe in that. That however talented you are, however driven, ambitious, you can't get to your full potential on your own.
Yeah.
You always need like-minded people. You need people to support you. You need people to encourage you, motivate you, think like you, believe in what you believe, to actually get where you want to get.
Milind, you launched an activewear brand for Indian women this year in January.
Yeah.
What made you venture into this?
So because of the Pinkathon, I saw that, you know, a lot of women, that there are reasons that women don't exercise. There are women reasons that women don't run. They don't do stuff for themselves. A big thing is time.
Hmm.
Because, of course, women are loaded with responsibilities, not just household responsibilities, but there are women who have jobs. They have their own businesses. They have all kinds of things to do, and they just then fail to take out time for themselves.
Yeah.
But a lot of the other reasons, like it could be, you know, not feeling comfortable in the clothes that they think are to be worn, you know, while exercising, like I'm wearing these shorts or t-shirts or tights or anything. And they're more comfortable. 99% of Indian women are comfortable wearing saris and salwar kameezes and that kind of silhouette. So I said, instead of forcefully getting them to say, okay, no, you must wear this or them, you know, to feel that I must do something like that, we'll create outfits that are more matching the Indian silhouette. So more like a kurti kind of feel, or a sari kind of feel, or, you know, that's something that appears like a salwar kameez but is much lighter, much more convenient. So the sari, in fact, we look at a sari normally as a 6 yards of fabric, so we use about 4.
So you've already launched this collection?
We've not launched the sari, but we've launched the kurtis, the yoga wears. On, if you go to devi.com, you'll see the range.
So how soon will we see the sari collection or the other sports
collection?
Well,
I'm very excited to see the sari as well. So we are experimenting. I mean, the thing is, it's not that women don't do all kinds of stuff on saris. Like earlier, when women used to ride cycles in India, 20 years ago, 30 years ago, they used to do it in saris. Today, somehow we've lost that concept or that drive to say, no, whatever I'm wearing, it doesn't matter, I'm going to do it. But my mother can run in a sari, and I've seen in the Pinkathon women running in saris, in salwar kameez, in burqa. So this is just to make it
A little more easy.
To make it, in fact, an incentive that this is a sari that's made for you to run in.
Yeah.
Now you can do it. So even when we started Pinkathon, everybody said that women are not going to run because they're not interested. They have a lot of work in the house.
Yeah.
They have to take care of the kids, make breakfast. They have to do puja. They have to, you know, help around. They have jobs. They have blah, 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 blah. Women have so many things to do. And we said, yes, of course they do. But I know that at the back of the mind, wherever we are thinking sanely, we understand that we need to do something. We need to take care of ourselves. So we are just creating a space.
Yeah.
Now women have to see it as their own and come then and be there. And that's what happened.
Take me through the price points, the garments that are available. What's the price range like, and what is really the USP of Devi?
The USP is basically the silhouette.
Hmm.
That's the USP. And we are saying that you don't have to wear clothes that you're uncomfortable in terms of the way it makes you look. It's going to make you look nice the way you're comfortable with. So we want to make a point of the fact that it's not the shape that is important. You know, there is no, I mean, I don't even want to say that the clothes are made for real women, because all women are real, whether you're slim or fat or chubby or tall, it doesn't matter. Those things don't matter. So you should not feel that it matters. You wear the clothes, you go out, you do your thing. That's it. So I know that a lot of brands show a certain shape and say this is the shape and the clothes are made for this shape. For us, it's not like that. Whoever you are, wherever you're from, whatever you look like, these are for you.
Okay. And the price range, what, like the minimum to the maximum?
The price range it's priced lower than most of the other sportswear and apparel brands.
Okay. And will you be looking at raising any more funds, because you obviously want to launch more collections, you want to expand? Are you looking at?
Definitely. I mean, all businesses do that. Our business, businesses expand.
Yeah.
So first, right now we are in a kind of experimental phase,
mm-hmm.
Where we're trying out lots of things. So we have launched with the first thing, which is the yoga wear, which is obviously people can understand that the easiest, because their yoga wear has been around for a long time.
Mm-hmm.
So now we've started yoga wear, and the next thing will be to get into more active than yoga.
All right, on that note, it's time for another short break, but don't go anywhere as we learn about Milind's fitness regime and we also put him on a quick rapid fire. Stay tuned.
CNBC TV18 Weekender.